Queensland's police union wants to buy the remote property where two officers and a local man were murdered in a shootout last week. The union says it doesn't want the place ending up in the wrong hands. Instead, it could be turned into a training centre or even a retreat. And the president of the Queensland Police Union, Ian Leavers, joins us now. Ian, why does the new union want to buy the house where the murders occurred?
We want to make sure that the anti-vaxxers and the pro-gun conspiracy theorists never get their hands on this property. But they have warped and dangerous views which should concern all Australians. What I'm hoping to achieve, and I've spoken with Anastasia Palaszczuk, and she is supportive of the idea, and I've spoken with Matthew's and Rachel's parents, and they are supportive of the idea. And the plan is to turn it into a positive place where it could be a retreat or used for training purposes for police, and it will be named in honour of Matthew and Rachel. It's just not fitting that any other person with a warped and dangerous views, which are un-Australian, would ever have access to this property and would further promote their un-Australian views.
So are you of the belief that those that live in that community, however you want to describe it, nearby, would want to themselves own this property or use it in some way?
Look, those who are nearby, they are positive people. There are a lot of bachelors out that way. But if we have it for the police union, for the benefit as a retreat for current and serving police, as well as for police training purposes, I believe that will be a positive thing in the community. Because from what I've seen, the people of Tara and Chinchilla, they're just hard-working, decent people, and they are horrified by the acts that took place last Monday by this ruthless, murderous trio who executed our colleagues in cold blood, as well as their neighbour, Alan, who didn't deserve to die either.
Ian, the Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese, says that National Cabinet will now look to strengthen gun regulation, and that's something that you've been calling for since this tragedy happened. How do you keep guns out of criminals' hands?
That is a real challenge for us, but what we can do with a national database where all the information is available to the 66,000 police across Australia, that they have the same information which is readily available at their fingertips. Because we have eight different systems, eight different jurisdictions, which just don't talk to each other. It is cumbersome and chunky, and it's really setting us up to fail. And we need to talk in the same language and the same terminology. So this will assist police with our intelligence, with our risk assessments, and the safer and the better we can be prepared means we can do a better job in protecting the community. But sadly, there are those within the community who they disobey the law and they will never do the right thing. But what we do need to do is keep track of those who have a firearms licence, those who acquire weapons, dispose of weapons, as well as what they have in their possession, as well as any offences that are being committed, so we have all the available information to assist us to do our jobs.
A public memorial will be held for the two fallen officers in Brisbane tomorrow. Ian, thank you so much for your time tonight.
Thank you very much.